Are you tired of sports handicappers giving you losing picks? Feel like some sports handicappers' claims are too good to be true?
This guy is 104-7 in his last 111 G Delta Foxtrot 62 Epsilon plays that were played on a day of the week starting with a T with a start time between 7 and 8:30 p.m. Mountain Time that featured a player on the team who went to high school in Memphis, Tennessee? This guy must be good. Where's my American Express?
Feel like you're flushing your money down the toilet? Tired of finding yourself in this position because of bad sports handicapper plays? Well, you need the Sports Handicapper Flowchart.
The Sports Handicapper Flowchart?
Sports Betting Truth's Sports Handicapper Flowchart is an easy step-by-step process to determine which sports handicappers are good and which are not. The Sports Handicapper Flowchart takes all the guesswork out of it, so you can go from this to this. So if you're sick of making this face, there is help. Use the Sports Handicapper Flowchart today.
Thanks, Sports Betting Truth.
Hey guys, welcome back to Sports Betting Truth. And today's topic is going to be about sports handicappers, because as the teaser video showed, there's a lot of sports handicappers out there. How do you know if they're good? How do you know if they're bad? How do you know if it's worth spending money on them or following their picks? How do you know? Well, here at Sports Betting Truth, I have the solution for you. I have come up with the ultimate flow chart. I call it the Sports Handicapper Flow Chart that is going to show you a decision tree to make the right decision on which sports handicappers to follow, pay for, or ignore. Trust me, there will be no more guesswork after this. This flow chart is your go-to resource to determine which sports handicappers out there are worth it. And without any further ado, here is the Sports Handicapper Flowchart. So the first question you want to ask in this flowchart, do they sell picks? Just a simple yes or no question. If the answer is yes, then they suck. Do not buy picks from them. If the answer is yes, if they sell picks, then they suck. Guys, it's that simple. Period. Yes, 100% of them, no exceptions. Yes, really. I know it's going to happen. There's going to be people in the comments section that says, yeah, most touts are bad, but there's some good ones out there. There's some honorable ones out there. No, guys, if they sell picks, they suck, and they're not worth buying picks from. Period. It's that simple. End of discussion. There are no good touts out there. And I know it's bad to act in absolutes, but trust me, guys, if they sell picks, they suck. Don't pay them. Don't spend any money on them. I don't care how much their marketing gimmicks and campaigns and everything makes it seem like they're good. I don't care how many people they have shilling for them about how great they are. If they sell picks, they suck. Don't buy picks from them. All right, continue with the flow chart. If the answer is no, if they are a sports handicapper giving out picks for free or whatever, on Twitter, social media, Instagram, Reddit, message boards, it doesn't matter. If the answer is no, then be suspicious. I have a lot of people that say, yeah, I don't pay touts for picks, but just go out there and find like a good free one on Twitter or social media that gives out picks for free. That's the way to go. Just find someone who's good. And I always say, okay, but what are their motives? What would be the motives of somebody giving out picks for free? If someone was really that good, because trust me, most of the people give out free picks suck. But what if someone was really that good giving out just free winners that were a consistent long-term winner, what's their motivation? What's the motivation for giving that out for free? And there's a lot of answers to that question. The first and foremost, the number one reason and motivation behind a free sports handicapper is they're going to turn tout eventually. Here's how it works. These people create like dozens of different social media accounts that are about free picks, right? And the law of averages says that at least one of those accounts are going to go hot at some point. I mean, the more accounts you have, the more likelihood you're going to hit a heater on one of them, right? Even if your other 35 don't work. So what these people do is the accounts that they create that aren't good, they delete them and then create new ones in their place, hoping to hit a hot streak. And the ones that do well, that gain a following, they turn tout with. It's the oldest trick in the book. I've seen it play out a million times. That is first and foremost the number one motivation behind free sports handicappers. Ignore all their BS about, oh, I'm not in it for the money. I'm just giving out these picks for the good of my own heart, right? Ignore all that. Trust me, For most of them, the game is to eventually turn tout after they hit a heater. That's how it works. I've seen it play out a million times. But then the ones who don't have the motivation to turn tout, what is their motivation? Well, a lot of them, it's just about vanity. They want to become someone who is worshipped by the masses about how great they are at giving out sports picks. It's a vanity project. And guess what? When that account goes cold, guess what they're going to do? They're going to disappear just like the people that are trying to turn tout. I've seen it happen many times. You know, I'm not going to say the name because I did not respect the account. But there is a guy on Reddit who gave out college basketball picks for free that gained a cult following on there because he had a hot run for a month or two, right? But then, like everybody else, he regressed to the mean and started to lose, and he was down because this guy talked a big game, and he is one of those, I just give these out for the goodness of my own heart, aka I'm trying to gain a following of people to worship me. And, you know, he said he bet like $10,000 a game, blah, blah, blah. And all of a sudden, you know, he was down a lot of money and he just disappeared. And all the people that were worshiping him and following him were either, A, had Stockholm syndrome and like were trying to rationalize, saying he's going to come back eventually, guys, don't give up, like a cult. And then there's other people who are really angry, you know, I can't believe I got hoodwinked by this guy. But either way, the reason I have the Futurama Fry not sure picture up there is because what's the motivation behind these guys? And ultimately, like, is it worth it? People say just find a good free handicapper, but I'm like, how do you know that they're good? How do you know if their long-term record is good? You know, why not just do the work yourself? And I know what people are going to say. They're going to be like, well, you give out your picks on your website. What's your motivation? Well, my motivation for giving out my picks on sportsbettingtruth.com is not to gain a following, not to turn tout, not to have people worship me. Because I'm going to show you right now, sportsbettingtruth.com. You want to know why I do what I do? Because most of my channel is about models, right? And I talk about creating models. Here's my college basketball model. You think I would have this up that my model was down 71 units this past college basketball season on plays that I made? You think I would have that up if I was trying to turn talent or gain a following? No. I post my plays for the educational aspect because I always talk about building models, and I want to show you guys how my models actually perform so you guys can have a realistic expectation of what to expect if you put time and effort to build a model, right? So that's why I post my plays. That's my motivation, the educational factor. Because really, if you really had good picks out there, would you give them away for free? Probably not. And I know what people are going to circle back to when I say all pick sellers are bad, right? And the main reason is, if your picks are really as good as they say, why wouldn't you just bet them yourself and enrich yourself with your amazing picks that you're marketing, right? And I know what the common retort to that is, well, why not do both? Why not sell your picks and bet them yourself? Trust me, guys, if a tout was really that good, he would move lines the instant he came out with a play. So if a tout bet that play and then gave it out and he was any good, the lines would move and then his clients would not be able to get that price. But trust me, guys, touts are not moving lines. So it means like the market does not respect their plays and therefore they're not worth it. So if a tout really was good and was actually moving lines, he would not give out his plays because he wouldn't want the lines to move. He could bet them and then the lines would move. Yeah, that's fine. But all his clients would be screwed and not get good prices. And that's the story. Anyway, that is a tout flowchart. Again, if they sell picks, they suck. Period. Do not buy picks from them. That's how it works. No exceptions. I don't care what people in the comments section say below. That's how it is. So guys, probably not what a lot of you are expecting, especially if you've never watched this channel before, but that is the cold hard truth about these so-called sports handicappers out there. I wouldn't trust any one of them, right? Don't spend any money on them at the very least. If you want to go ahead and follow a free one, that's up to you, but at the very least, do not spend money on them, guys. They're all worthless. Yes, 100% of them are worthless. There are no exceptions. And that's the truth. That is the truth. That's what this channel is about. Sports betting truth. The truth about sports betting. And the truth is, there's no good handicappers out there, aka touts. Ignore them. Don't give them the time of day. Anyway, I hope you liked this video. If you did, hit the like button so videos like this instead of tout videos will be boosted to the top of the YouTube algorithm when it comes to sports betting content. Anyway, until next time, this is Sports Betting Truth, signing off.